guys, so today I have a tutorial for you. I'm going to be using this Sephora Black Magic palette. This was actually a gift for my birthday back on August 5th. So if you want to see what I'm doing here, then just keep on watching. First, I'm going to start off with some e.l.f. eyelid primer. And I'm almost out of this particular tube, but I do have another one in there. I'm just waiting for this one to be totally done. And I do like to use it underneath my eyes as well to help prevent my concealer later on from creasing in those little fine lines. Now I'm going to lay down some bases. This first one I'm taking is a Flower Beauty Cream Shadow in Lilac You A Lot. And then I'm also going to be taking this e.l.f. Cream Eyeliner in Plum Purple and kind of using that along the lash line and then like in the crease and stuff like that to deepen up my base. And I do like to use a flat kind of concealer brush for this Flower Beauty one. And I'm just going to place that all over my lid area. I actually think it's just easier to use my finger for this cream eyeliner from e.l.f. Just dabbing it on that outer corner. And then also taking a more flat, tiny little brush to run it along my lower lash line. I'm going to be using this light champagne kind of color all over my lid area. So it kind of gives the shadow a little more depth now. You have that purple underneath with the champagne on top, so you get the golden kind of color of the champagne, but also little specks of the purple and its metallicness underneath. Overall, it's still light, but it gives it a little more dimension. So I'm taking this darker teal kind of color and using that on the outer section. Just because it's matte, it's gonna take away a little bit of the shimmeriness of the overall look. I'm just going to blend that into the lid color. You can always play around with the color of your bases when using a different shadow on top. They can really give a different look depending on what kind of base you are using underneath. Now I'm just going to add some of this purple color to that outer section as well. I really like these darker shades. They are so dark that you don't need a black to help deepen it up, but you can still tell that it's an actual color. It's not just like gray or black. Then just going back in and blending again and starting to feather in above my crease area to bring a little more darkness inward. I'm just doing it right above the crease. I don't want to darken up that lid section. Next, I'm going to take that purple again and I'm going to use it along my lower lash line. And also dragging it to connect the upper and lower sections. Then going back in with that teal and adding it to the mixture along my lower lash line. Just blending the two together. Now it's time for all the boring stuff like liner, mascara, all of that junk. I'm going to be using Milani's Liquify Eyeliner on my tightline and waterline. As usual, this is one of my very, very favorites. So I just used the black on about the outer third of my waterline. Now I'm going to go in with a nude pencil to line the rest of it. So I'm also going to take this black pencil and I'm going to use it along my upper lash line, focusing on the outer third, making that a little heavier as well. Using a pencil just helps create a softer liner instead of like a harsh liner that would come from a pen or from a cream eyeliner. So eyes complete, let's move on to the face. So I already applied this Murad Oil Control Mattifier with SPF 15 earlier this morning, so that's already on my face. Now I'm going to go in with Revlon Photo Ready Primer, the Perfecting Primer in 001. And I'm just going to focus that on my cheek area and on my forehead and my chin, the places that get a little oily for me. Even though I'm pretty sure that Murad stuff was a decent primer in the first place. Next, I'm going to take this NYX Full Coverage Concealer in the green one. I'm just going to use that on some spots that get a little red for me. I like to use it on my nose to kind of cover up my freckles and my redness there. And then also around the sides of my nose and actually on my cheeks. I should probably just buy one of those green tinted primers. It would probably be a lot easier than spreading this like all over my face. And if I didn't have such heavy eye makeup on, I would put some on the outer corners of my eyes because I have a redness right at the very outer corners of both of my eyes, so this stuff works to cancel that out. But the black, the dark colors of my shadows are kind of covering that up enough for me, and I don't want to end up messing it up by putting stuff too close to it. So now I'm going to use my Hard Candy Glamouflage Heavy Duty Concealer under my eyes. This not only is a concealer like for my dark circles, which I really don't think it's that awesome at concealing dark circles, but whatever. But it also makes me use less foundation when I put it on first, because I have this whole like triangle section of my face covered already, so I don't have to use as much foundation. I know a lot of people say you shouldn't do it that way, you should put your foundation on first and then your concealer, but I just personally like it this way a lot better. Lately, at least, that's what I've been doing lately. And I always like to do my eyes first because anytime I don't, I'll end up with fallout like all over the place. It's just a big old mess. It's a pain in the butt. I'd just much rather do my eyes first, get all that shadow taken care of, and then go back in and do my face. And I'm going to be using Revlon's Colorstay foundation. This is still probably too much, especially since I just put on all of this concealer. I guess I'll just extra cake it on today. I hate wasting product. That concealer also does a really good job of brightening up my under eye area because it is a little too light for me. And by a little, I mean it's quite light. I like to use the side of my beauty blender when I do my foundation because there's like way more surface area and you can just get your face done quicker instead of just using the bottom, in my opinion. That was actually like the perfect amount. Then after I've done my foundation, I always like to go back in with whatever brush I was using for blending and pat back over this outer section because I always end up getting a teeny tiny bit of concealer or foundation or something out here that's interfering with my shadows. So in order to bring them back to how they were before, I just like to take that same brush that I was using earlier and blend them out again. I'm also going to go in with a matte white from my NYX Bohemian Chic palette and place that under my brow and also in the inner corner. Now it's time for brows, and I'm using this Chella Dazzling Dark Brown Eyebrow Color Pencil. And taking this e.l.f. Treat and Tame Eyebrow Gel. This one is actually in the color Ash, because most of my brow products are too red toned, so I wanted to get this one that was more ashy to try and cancel that out or neutralize it or something. So now it's time for my face, and I'm going to take NYX's blush in Taupe as usual to contour. And taking my Coastal Scents 10 blush palette. I'm going to use the super hot pink one, but hopefully just lightly, not too crazy pink. And some e.l.f. blush in Gotta Glow for a highlight. So, taking Urban Decay's Anarchy in this teeny tiny little baby lipstick. So adorable. I'm going to apply that. So this is the completed makeup look. I really hope you guys enjoyed. If you did like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and I'll talk to you really soon. Bye! Just twisting until I feel like it is secure enough. I also must say these things are not the most comfortable to sleep in. I remember I used to use regular, like, old school foam rollers in, like, my middle school.